Y'all got some real nasty lines off back in the 90s.
When I met you, I admit my first thought was a trick. You look so good, huh? I suck on your daddy's dick.
I know you watching this. You got a lot of explaining to do, buddy.
Wow. I knew we were going here. So aside from the entire Biggie line, you already know Big to me is like in my top. That line was, even when you first heard it, you're like, whoa. DJ, stop the track.
Yeah.
Bring it back. Did he? Oh, wow. He said that?
During that time, it was very convenient to hide things in your ass and talk about sucking, I guess. Sorry.
I guarantee right now, rest his soul, if Big was still alive, of all the lines in his life, he probably would recant that one. Just because of all the music that he had, that was literally the first song that he really dedicated to a female.
Which is nuts.
Literally.
Yeah.
Because apparently he wanted to have the nuts of his girl's dad.
Now that we have you here,
mm-hmm.
What was Biggie thinking?
Wow, I knew we were going here.
What was Biggie thinking when he said,
"When I met you, I admit my first thought was a trick. You look so good, huh? I suck on your daddy's dick."
I love it.
And another question, right?
Yeah.
What is up with all the 90s rappers talking about, like, I'm going to rob you out of your clothes? Like, why do they have to be naked to get robbed?
You know? I love it. So I'm gonna take it back to front, okay? And yo, Cam, I love Cam. Cam is wild. He'll say whatever, which is dope because he's had literally said, you know, but that era, okay? So to get deep on that, the entire, I think it was Belly. Belly was a movie where my man got robbed and they stripped him down. So the thing about it is when you're hustling, okay, you hide your money in a lot of different inconspicuous spaces because you didn't want the police. So the way that they were doing it, they were robbing dudes to strip them down because they knew that you may actually stick a pack up, you know, the poop chute or, you know. So in that aspect of the game, people were robbing people and stripping them all the way down because they knew you might have $5,000 in your sock and maybe a quarter of something up your old rum shaker. So, you know, that was the whole point of that. And Big, like, yo, I'm gonna tell you, man, it, so aside from the entire Biggie line, you already know Big to me is like in my top. So, you know, but that's a rough line. That was a hard pill to swallow. And even at the era, in the midst of that.
Whoa! Hey, yo!
Yeah, you know, it was loose, man. That line was loose. Even at the era, when you first heard it, you're like, whoa. DJ, stop the track.
Yeah.
Bring it back. Did he? Oh, wow, he said that?
You know what's crazy about it is, like, if that was me, I would stay very far away from that kind of line because I know it's a little sus. But this man was like up there and he rapped it. And not only did he rap it, when he said that part,
everybody,
all his homies
wild.
Chimed in. That was really just wild.
Yeah,
that
was
a little
the line,
crazy.
Though. That was the line. That was during that time, it was very convenient to hide things in your ass and talk about sucking dick, I guess.
Sorry. Yeah, that line. I mean, you know, I guarantee right now, rest his soul, if Big was still alive, of all the lines in his life, he probably would recant that one. Just because, not only that, that was a song that he was dedicated, of all the music that he had, that was literally the first song that he really dedicated to a female, which is crazy.
Which is nuts.
Literally.
Yeah.
Because apparently he wanted to have the nuts of his of his girl's dad.
He was bisexual, didn't tell anybody.
For those who don't know, my dad used to work at Power 92 back in its heyday or whatever.
Yeah.
And
shouts out to that.
You had a lot of like time to, you know, see some of the stars before like they were like kind of blowing up and stuff.
Yeah.
So like, what were some of the people that you got to like interact with during that time?
Wow, that's crazy. Shouts out to Power 92, man. I worked with some great people, man. Young Dink, Ron, man, Maze, man. I mean, it's people, man, I can't even think of like the celebs. I'm gonna tell you a good story, man. And I doubt the rapper would ever remember this situation, but me and my friend Dink at the time. So I was, what I did was when I first started working at Power 92, I was working for the street team. And we met T.I. I met T.I. twice. And like I said, you know, it's one of those situations you probably wouldn't remember. The first time I met him, he wasn't Big. He was still like literally pulled up in the version now of a Sprinter van, like an Econoline van with like his security, whatever.
You didn't have Tiny with him, huh?
Yeah, nah, dude. Yeah, he was like super duper. And we like stopped him and we kind of just chopped it up. Like, yo, you know, you're hot right now. I think he had the Rubber Band song.
Rubber Band Man?
Yeah.
Okay.
Or 24 is one of the two songs. It was like really hot, but he was just, you know, Turn the City, whatever. And we stopped him and he literally was like chopping it up, like really like the man, you know. And then the next time I met him was a different situation because now he's a little bit more famous and he's doing an in-store at a record store right next to Mather High School. Like okay. There used to be a little record store. I don't remember the name of it. But this time it was with this guy called the Freaking Puerto Rican, which he was dope. He was a radio station personality. He was a real good dude, man. But this time, yo, T.I., mad love, bro. Legend of underground hip hop. But at the time, T.I. had smoked probably himself into existence. So he was mad high. And, you know, it happens because I've seen a lot of rappers like that. But this dude was super high and he was just filling out autographs. And we're interviewing him, like the radio station's interviewing him. And he just was a little too high to interview on the radio in front of kids that are leaving the high school. So it was just one of those weird situations. But yeah, you know, that situation, man, like me and T.I., you just see where people are at now. You know, we've seen Nelly and my A-Key story. So I met Alicia Keys. So my man Dink was there another time. Shouts out to Dink, young Dink. He's a legend, Virgo. Let's go. So we did a show. So Alicia Keys had just dropped her first album, right? And Diary of, you know, Diary of Alicia Keys. And I Keep on Falling was literally the joint. Like it was the song everywhere. So she did a private session at Isaac Hayes used to have a club down kind of north side, whatever. So Isaac Hayes had this club, it was a little in store, whatever. And we setting up the place the whole time. I'm young and fly at the time. You know, I'm probably like 22, 23. And I'm like, yo, I tell my man Dink, I'm going to get at her, man. If I see A-Keys, bro, I'm on her. Like, I'm on, bro, you can't tell me. I'm like, and he's like, yo, you going to get her? I'm like, yeah, man, she's so fly, da, da, da. And she comes. So we're putting up signs, put up our Power 92, you know, setting up the venue for making it look real sexy, whatever. And this chick walks in with a floppy hat. And she's like, yo, where I put my stuff? And I turn and it was A-Keys. And I literally just froze. And I was just like, and he was like, yo. And I'm like, and he's like, hey, you put your stuff right there, man. Your people, da da da. And he's ushering. He turns, he was like, yo, you're a sucker, man. I was like, I probably didn't talk maybe for like 45 minutes, man. But like, you know, I mean, amazing. She's a queen, whatever. Shouts out to her. But like, it was at that time, I was just like, you know, just starstruck.
But you were in attendance the night Kanye got his Rockefeller check.
Yeah, man.
Uh-oh. Kanye. Got some big news for Shia. You want something? And I'm the newest member of the Rockefeller team.
So the company that I was working for at the time was doing promotion for Power 92. That's how I got linked with them. But they also, they were working for Rockefeller. So Rockefeller, we were Rockefeller street team. And crazy, crazy situation. So we're at the time, this is a show in Tinley Park, and I can't remember, but it was a big festival. And the headliners of the show was Jay and the Rockefeller, Jay-Z was a headliner, but, you know, of course, he brought his team out. But opening up for Jay, and I told him this, was Cypress Hill. I can't remember a couple other groups, but it was Cypress Hill and the Roots. So, not Roots, sorry, Fugees.
Yeah.
Fugees. Yeah, so it was a dope show. And me and, again, yo, Dink was my man, so I always got to shout him out because he was there for everything. But we happened to be there, and we were in Tinley Park at the show. Nanny sunned me, I told you that. So we're because we're the street team, you know, we're on stage. And, you know, we're like, man, we got Rockefeller shirts and we put up all your stuff. And we seen Jay and we're like, hey, Jay, we're your team. And he was just like, who is these dudes? And he just kept walking. But yeah, so the show was on. Jay had the show. It was dope. It was dope. And then he brings out Kanye, which we knew because ironically enough, shouts out to Pugly Adams, you know, big artist in Chicago at the time. Pugs went to high school with him, so he knew Kanye, and he would always have these Kanye stories about, or he went to art school or something, but they were tight, and he was like, yo, I know this dude, this is Kanye West, and we had heard him, everybody kind of, you know, knew him at the time, but he came on, he's like, yo, I'm gonna bring my man out, and he brought Kanye out, gave him the chain, the entire crowd went crazy, man, it was bananas, video, yeah. Man, yeah, and it was just one of those things that we were literally like, I want to say, man, like 50, 60 feet from the whole thing, looking at him from stage, which just made it so much more surreal, you know? But yeah, that was a dope situation. Yeah, I got my stories about everybody.
Did you ever get a chance to like meet Kanye or be in the same kind of vicinity?
Oh, here we go.